set the current fleet and industry issues in context. You have a limit of 289 heavy carriage vehicles. That was imposed on the 23rd of January 2012. At the time we actually did the bank work, which was in March, there were 258 vehicles on the books. So the operational performance we're talking about is really based on that level of 258 vehicles. That's how many were available to service the demand we were observing. One of the things that, as we looked at the stats, is very important. In this area, the Hackney Carriage fleet provides the bulk of wheelchair accessible vehicles from the area. All the Hackney Carriages are wheelchair accessible, but there are not many, if any, wheelchair accessible vehicles on the private hire site. When the limit was first removed, many private hire vehicles actually transferred to Hackney Carriage, and that reduced the levels of private hire, increased the level of Hackney Carriage. But when you look at the stats since the limit's been back on, private hire levels would often increase when that happened, but actually they also decreased as well as the Hackney Carriages decreasing, which is saying something about the actual demand for licensed vehicles in the area. And interestingly, the number of private hire vehicles at the moment is about the same as it was in 2012 when the limit was first imposed. Driver numbers have also been reducing on both sides, except for in the last year when there's been a slight increase in Hackney Carriage and private hire in this last year. We went to rewatch what happened at length. This is the main place that you can see what's going on with Hackney Carriages. We looked at 245 hours. We found Fridays and Saturdays were the busiest, but actually quite similar to one another. When you look at the graph that's there, and I have some larger copies of the graph if people do want them, basically there's very little patterns overnight. You can see this, often you'll have things that go down and they'll stay there, whereas the graph clearly shows Friday night there's a dip here in the early hours of Saturday, and Saturday night is a dead period in the early hours of Sunday. It's slightly more busy in the Saturdays than it is on Fridays, but basically, you know, things die once you get later on. Very clearly from the graph, the busiest rank is Aster in Birkenhead, which gives you 40% of the estimated passenger numbers in a typical week. Clawton Road, just around the corner from that, gets 18%. Ranking Liscard 16%. New Brighton does have some active carriage activity, but it's not focused on the formal bank. When we actually did a comparison back to 1998, overall active carriage demand compared to then is about 25% less. However, the data we just collected in 2017 was 42% higher than the data that was collected in the last study in 2012, the time at which the limit was put on. That's mainly down to the Asda Bank, which when the previous survey was done, Asda was being developed. So that wasn't whatever the equivalent, so we're doing quite so much. Since the last survey in 2012, a lot of night and other venues have actually closed. Interestingly, in the meantime, there have been developments of the new Brighton which have come, and now they're gone. However, we did find that there still remain six active ranks, one of which gets fair service, four of them get good service, and one of them gets very good service. So that's quite a good track record for what the ranks are achieving. And when we actually checked on the vehicles we saw about half of the Hackney Carriage fleet during the Friday. Sample to shopping. We did some